Okay, there's this really bad dude named Hacker.
Me! To you?
Whatever. He wants to take over the cyber world from Motherboard. The three kids are sucked into cyberspace, and they use brain power to help save everybody.
Okay, here's the plan.
So they travel all over and run into all these weird creatures and have all these awesome adventures. It's totally up to them to save cyberspace. Can three cool kids and a wacky bird outsmart the Hacker?
Never!
There's only one way to find out.
Tune in to CyberChase.
CyberChase, we're moving. We're beating Hacker at this game. Don't tell me that he's trying to hack the motherboard. We'll get him every time.
Cosmic world, freaky places that we see. We got the power of 1, 2, 3, 4.
Running in a CyberChase, we meet him face to face. We'll stick together all the time.
Adventures in cyberspace, the chase is on.
If we
Horizon, we have the Parthenon, one of the prides of Delphi.
Delphi? We're in Corsica, you goat-headed fool.
Corsica? That chance, you fool-headed goat. We're in Delphi.
Try Athens, guys. The Parthenon was built in the mid-5th century BC to honor the Greek goddess Athena.
I knew that.
You did?
Well, I know Matt knew it. The kid's a walking encyclopedia of geek mythology.
That's Greek mythology, Didge.
Where's everybody going?
To listen to the music of the spheres.
When the music plays, all is right on our cyber sight. Happens 3 times a day.
Twice, noon, and sunset.
What could be better? A vacation and a rock concert.
A siren, a muse, Apollo, and a beast.
Check it out, Cyber TV.
Zeus says that if the band doesn't play the music exactly right, it will lead to total chaos and cacophony!
Chaos and what?
Noise! If the music isn't just right, the balance of our cyber sight will be destroyed.
Man, talk about pressure.
What's taking so long? Where are you?
We're in, boss. We're backstage.
Want any autographs while we're here?
Just mess up the music of the spheres!
What's up, dudes?
Groovy!
Groovy?
Hey, the group must be in here.
I'm so handsome, I should be cast in bronze.
Hate to tell you, Apollo, honey, but big muscles went out with Hercules. My unique sense of style is what our fans crave.
I weep for you both. If not for the poetic inspiration that burns within my tortured soul, our band would be like a mere nothing.
Your inspiration, Calliope? Perhaps you're forgetting the beautiful tone I bring to my gong.
You play with the subtlety of a cyclops, Apollo. It's my horn that whips people into a frenzy.
No, children. Our group would be nothing without the intense spirituality I bring to my lyre.
And our songs wouldn't be anything if I didn't.
Yeah, right.
We know.
Who cares?
I care.
Hey, Beast, you want a donut?
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Our first musician is the Greek god of prophecy, archers, and musical inspiration. Let's give it up for Apollo!
The only way Odysseus could could resist this next little lady was to tie himself to a mast. Say hi to everybody's favorite siren. I'm a Roomba!
That is so cool. I have to learn how to do that.
Here she is, just back from inspiring Plato's Republic. Hold your titans for everybody's favorite muse, Calliope! And last, but not least, his hair may be a tangled mess, his smile may not launch a thousand ships, but he's the best darn drummer on four hooves. Give it up for the Beast! And here he is. Beast.
What are we going to do?
Let's play.
What about the beast?
Ah, who needs him anyway? Okay, go.
It sure didn't sound like this on the video.
They're totally off. You can't even clap to it.
Refresh my memory. What did you say will happen if the music isn't exactly right?
Chaos and cacophony!
Total destruction!
You thinking what I'm thinking?
Yep!
Hacker!
It's working! The music is awful! Soon the site will be mine!
The only weird thing I saw were these two roadies wandering around backstage. Tall metal guy with funny-looking horns that went zzz. And a short, stubby one eating a donut.
Buzz and Delete!
If Buzz and Delete were here, Hacker can't be far away.
And something tells me, if we find Hacker, we'll find the Beast.
Motherboard, it looks like you-know-who made off with the Beast.
Must find him before the sun sets. If Van plays just right by then, Sight will be saved.
Don't worry, we'll find him.
If not, one of you must replace the Beast so Van can play.
Wait a second. You mean take his place in the band and play his part?
Yes. Situation desperate.
How can we take the Beast's place? I mean, all we know is he beats the drum. But we don't have a clue when in the song he does it.
Let's ask the others in the band what the Beast's part is. They have to know.
While you're doing that, I'll look for the Beast and the Hat Pack. There's no time to waste.
Catch up with you later, Matt.
I was bad. Me, the Greek god of music. What will I tell Zeus?
Excuse me? Mr. Apollo?
Ah, a fan. Come to fawn at my feet.
Thanks. But I really came to help.
Help?
If I can find out what went wrong with your music, maybe we can fix it by sunset.
It was all Hymeropa's fault, that hair-obsessed stage hog. She threw us off.
I thought it was because the Beast didn't play.
The Beast? Who needs the Beast? All he does is bang that drum of his. Oh, he's so loud, it gives me a headache.
Well, we're looking for the Beast now. But in case we can't find him in time, can you tell me when during the song he beats the drum?
Let's see. He always starts us off with a beat. That's all I can remember.
Okay, so he starts. Then what do you do?
I count to three, striking my gong on three. Like this. One, two, three. One, two, three.
And you keep going?
Over and over, the gong on three. I repeat my part until the song is over. It is not as easy as you think.
So that's the deal, guys. The Beast starts them off, then Apollo counts and strikes his gong on three.
How many times does he do that?
Till the song ends. Whenever he reaches three, bang, he hits the gong.
Good job, Matt. Seems like Apollo's part is some kind of sound pattern that repeats over and over.
I bet the others have sound patterns in their parts, too.
Maybe if we figure out all the instrument patterns, we'll discover the part that's missing so we can play the drums if we have to. I'll log in Apollo's pattern.
Hurry! darkness is beginning to fall.
You need to go solo, big fella. Forget about Apollo. Blot out Calliope. Put Himaropa out of your mind. They don't care about you.
But I care about them. We've been together for eons.
Loyalty? You want loyalty? Stick with me, pal. I'll make you a star.
You deserve the best. A chauffeur limo.
A private jet.
Elegant dinners.
What do you say, handsome?
I don't think so. Our cyber site needs me.
Then think about this. I might even give you a pointy chin.
That's it. I'm leaving.
Okay. But forget about the chin.
Let's see. Orpheus had go right on the road to Corinth. Did that. Left at the Temple of Athena. And that's where I'll find the beast. Oh, beastie. Come out, wherever you are.
How about a trilogy on the Olympic Games?
Nah, it's been done.
Oh, what am I going to do? I haven't had a good idea in eons.
You know what, Homer? To be creative, one must commune with the forces of nature. Take a hike. Hello. Don't mind Homer. He's just got a bad case of writer's block.
Actually, I came to see you, Calliope.
Of course you did. Pull up a cushion. You from a magazine?
No. I came to talk about the beast.
I don't have time to pay attention to the mad drummings of an ungainly beast.
But if you don't play the music of the spheres exactly right at sunset, your cyber sight will be destroyed. Tell me about the beast. I need to know what he plays. Apollo says he always plays first, starting you off.
That sounds right. I can't recall the rest. But let's talk about something more exciting. Me.
Okay. What about your part?
I count to two and pluck my lyre on the second beat. Here, let me show you. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two.
And your pattern repeats again and again? The same way each time?
Every other count. Until the song is finished.
I've got it! An epic of heroic proportions. The Trojan War.
It's good to be a muse.
Hey, guys, more info.
Go for it.
I'm with you. After the beast starts, Calliope counts 1, 2, and plays her lyre on 2. Her pattern is to keep counting. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And she always plays on 2.
Cool. Now we've got 2 different sound patterns. The gong repeats every 3rd count. The lyre every other count.
It's beginning to sound like something. But we really need to know Himaropa's part of the song before it makes any sense. I'm almost there now.
Hurry, Jax.
If Digit doesn't find the beast soon, one of us is going to have to play those drums and play them right.
Excellent! The love you in Casablanca! If I can just keep that bongo-eyed beast here until tonight's concert is over, Mount Olympus will be mine!
You expect me to play on these? A rock star of my caliber deserves better!
The beast? Ha! How should I remember what that fur-challenged mastodon plays? Don't you want to hear about my part?
Sure. I was just going to ask.
I count to 4 over and over. And every time I get to 4, I play.
Can I hear how it sounds? The future of your cyber sight is at stake.
I know.
What are we gonna do?
Calm down. Just play your horn for me.
Well, I don't usually give private concerts, but if you count, I'll show you how my part goes.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I get it. What else can you tell me?
Well, we all play together for one beat, and then the song repeats. Divine, girls. Simply divine.
Guys, I've got the horn part. After the beast starts, Hymaropa toots her horn on the fourth count. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And they all play together on one beat just before the song repeats.
All right, we've got a sound pattern for each musician.
But our chart doesn't show us any time when they all play together.
Maybe they have to play longer before it all repeats. Try repeating Apollo and Calliope's parts a few more times and see what happens. It's going to work! Add one more of Hymaropa's part.
We did it! Look, we found a place where they all play together.
Cool! All three patterns match up on the 12th note.
And if they keep playing the same patterns, the music will repeat over and over again.
But that still doesn't tell us when the beast plays.
You've got a point there. Let's get the band to rehearse. Maybe then we can tell what's missing and figure out the beast pattern.
Come on! Oh, man, it sounds worse than before!
They're playing their parts the way they told us they do.
But something's definitely missing.
Oh, no! The sun is setting!
We're running out of time!
Come on, guys, think! What do we know?
We know that each musician plays their own sound pattern over and over.
And without the beast, their parts don't seem to fit together. His drum part must be the pattern they all depend on, or they wouldn't sound so bad without him.
But how do we figure out what that pattern is?
Back to the chart. I'll mark each beat in the pattern with a number. So now what do we know?
We know the beast starts playing on the first beat.
And we also know he plays on the 12th beat with the others, Hymaropa told me.
Look, no one plays on the 5th, 7th, or 11th beats. Maybe the beast plays there too.
I think we're getting somewhere. Let's hear what it sounds like with the real instruments.
Inez, you play the drums for the beast.
Me? Why me?
Desperate times call for desperate measures.
Who said that?
You do.
No good? Well, I guess that wasn't the right pattern.
No wonder it didn't work. Look, the drum doesn't have a regular pattern like the others. Don't you see?
I'm not sure.
Jackie's right. We need to find a pattern for the beast that repeats.
Something simple. Something that helps the others play. Remember when we saw the video of the band? How I was tapping my foot?
Yeah. And I was snapping my fingers.
And I was trying to clap. What's your point, Jax?
What was the pattern when I tapped my foot?
Beats me.
Exactly. A simple, steady beat. Watch. The same beat, over and over. 1, 1, 1, 1.
So are you saying the beast plays on every beat?
I think so. They all started off together.
But that pattern sounds so simple.
Let's chart it. Touchdown! All the patterns fit together.
And look, you can repeat the song after 12 beats.
That's gotta be it. The beat of the beast's simple pattern keeps the other three together.
Let's play it on the big board and see what we've got.
There's no more time to experiment. We've got to play now.
But...
Come on, Inez. I'll find something for you to wear.
But...
Only a few more minutes till sunset and cyber chaos!
Yes again, hacker!
Gidget!
And so tonight, we have a special treat.
Give it up for the Earth Girl with the glasses, Inez!
This is not good. This is not good at all.
Don't you see what Hack is trying to do? If you don't play with your band, Mount Olympus
Beast will be thrown into chaos.
Listen to me, Beast. I'm gonna make you a star. Starting in Casablanca tomorrow night.
No, he isn't. He's lying to you so he can wreck this cyber site.
Get him!
Ask him where in Casablanca you're going to play. Ask him!
Where in Casablanca am I going to play?
Where?
Well,
See? He doesn't have a clue. I know that the band treated you badly, but they won't take you for granted anymore. They need you. Cyberspace needs you.
Enough! Let the chaos commence!
Admit it, you four-feathered fowl, you've lost! Oh, Mama!
Out of the way, rabbit ears!
Go ahead and play, but you're too late. Soon, the hacker will be the king of cyberspace!
Silence!
Get up, Susie!
I hope I can do this, guys.
You can do it, Inez. Just follow your inner muse.
Okay, and you just follow my beat. Oh no, I lost the pattern of the beat.
Try again, Inez. It's your drum that's keeping everyone together.
Just remember, play on every beat. One, 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 one.
Okay, guys, one more time. On the beat.
The beast has returned! Stop the music!
You sure you still need me?
You bet we do, Beast. Let's rock this joint!
Actually, let's see if we can stop the rocking. Hit it!
Beat those drums, you conniving kid, but you'll never beat me!
Oh, yes, we will, Hacker. We'll beat you every time.
You can count on that.